On the 25th of January 1995, Eric Cantona was about to leave a massive imprint on world football.
Other players realised that he had possibly the shortest fuse and it didn't need a lot to ignite, you know. And when it did go off, then, as we know, he really went off.
Still, I lose my temper sometimes.
Man United travelled to Crystal Palace, hoping to catch up Premiership leaders Blackburn. This was Palace's biggest game of the season, and the atmosphere was electric.
With the throw-in, his manager looks on. Shaw and Cantona clash. Get out there, Cantona.
Early in the second half, and the score level at 0-0, Schmeichel cleared the ball towards Eric Cantona, who ran into a Palace player. The ref showed him the red card, and boy, was he not happy.
He got sent off. He was very disappointed with himself.
He got tackled by Richard Shaw and then volleyed Richard Shaw up in the air and then expressed some surprise that he'd been sent off for this. And obviously he's a Man United player, so he's been told that they're not allowed to be sent off. And obviously he was right that this rule had been infringed.
It's a red card for Eric Cantona.
I never did it because I don't care, even if I am sent off.
This season of scandal was about to reach a spectacular climax.
We were listening to the radio and I was working late at Loaded and the phrase was, what's Eric done now?
It's enough fun to watch him strutting off the pitch, his Gallic nose up, you know, defiant as ever. And then suddenly, when he's just off, over into the crowd, I was just stunned. I couldn't believe it.
Manchester United's French star Eric Cantona was sent off in the Premiership match against Crystal Palace tonight and then got into a fight with a fan.
What Cantona did next has since been banned from being shown on television. Football Years can now show the incident in full.
What's he doing here? Cantona's got into the crowd to attack a fan. He's completely lost it. I've never seen anything like this. Cantona.
And it wasn't just the fact that he went for him, was it? It was the full karate kick was just fantastic.
It's very shocking because he shouldn't have done it. He really, really shouldn't have done it.
The fact that he went in with his feet was bang out of order. And he used to do that on the pitch as well, kind of, if there was an off, he'd kick someone. If he'd have gone in with his fist, no problem.
If you watch the right-hander, if you watch the right-hander, what follows it up, you'll know what I mean, that he doesn't need any minders, that's for sure.
Cantona said he was provoked by a torrent of anti-French abuse from the fan he attacked.
This fella, he's coming down from like the back row and he's in very bad English, very rude English, telling him to go back to France. And that wasn't the right thing to say to Cantona at that particular time.
It's great for some fan who can stand there yelling at the abuse, not thinking he's going to get anything bad because he's hidden away.
Just to see the look of the faces in the people in the crowd when they saw this 6'2" Frenchman fly towards them, it's just worth the admission money on its own for going to Sellers Park that day. Whatever the guy said, he shouldn't have been kicked. But having said that, it was incredibly funny.
Imagine there was 8,000 people stood outside your work chanting and abusing you. You'd only stand there for so long. So I think that was actually pretty ordinary behaviour and it's how most of us would have reacted.
The FA had never had to deal with this type of incident before and the press made it clear they wanted serious action. While the man who had been on the wrong end of Cantona's right boot was still in shock.
I know Eric Cantona realises he shouldn't have done it. I would like an apology from Eric Cantona, and then I would decide to do what I'll do from there.
I'm so tired of playing.
United announced they would ban Cantona for the rest of the season and fine him a record £20,000. At a press conference, Cantona took the opportunity to express his innermost thoughts on the incident.
The press conference just made it even more infamous because he just came out with all this bollocks, really.
When the seagulls.
That made it even sort of more remarkable. The way all these journalists must have been sitting there writing it down. The seagull, I think this is going to be a great ending. There'll be a great ending here. It's going to have a real killer. It's going to be fantastic. And he just finished. And they must have all sat there and thought, did you get that? Right. The whole country just laughing, you know.
It was just like typical Eric. I mean, he could have just said whatever he wanted to. And the nature of the press is that they will analyse whatever you say. So, he's since admitted that he just made it up.
Despite Cantona's defiance, he actually faced the possibility of imprisonment. The FA banned him from playing for 9 months, and he was eventually sentenced to 120 hours community service. His punishment was to teach kids football.
When I used to take penalties training, I could never score, but he said, just choose a corner, concentrate on it, and just shoot there. So we did, and kept him going in.
He's all, he was just willing, he was just good.
They given that to me, like a punishment, but it wasn't. I enjoyed it very much.
So, Eric, Mr. Clean Cantona, I have to say, in all sincerity, you're a changed man.
Yes, indeed, John. Yes. From now on, I am going to, be as good as gold and let my football do the talking.
The referee, you're an asshole!
Well, I say.